Welcome to Talk Fights. I'm Curtis Biggs. Today I have my brother with me again, Adam Biggs. This past weekend we went to Windsor for another Prospect Fighting Championships event. As usual, we had a great time. We saw some really cool people there. Ran into an amateur and professional boxer named Adam Troopish from Windsor. Troopish was a spectacular amateur with 199 fights who went to the Olympics twice, in Greece and in Beijing, China. Turning professional, he won the Canadian, middleweight championship in about 4 months of turning pro, which put him as the fastest person to do it in over 100 years. In his next fight, he fought for the super middleweight Canadian championship, winning that. Also went as far as winning the NABA North American championship. Adam Troopers was a superstar. He's a spectacular amateur athlete, one of the best ever to come out of Canada. What did you think of the rest of the night?
It was a great night of fights. It was a good lineup. Elias Theodorou had his first fight since being released from the UFC. The Laramie brothers were there, although one of them didn't get to have his fight. There was his opponent had some personal issues. He couldn't make it.
So, yeah, Tony was unable to fight, unfortunately.
Yeah, it was a great night of fights. There were some wars, some stoppages, some submissions. It was good.
Absolutely, it was a ton of fun. Here's a little bit of footage from the fights. Former UFC fighter Elias Theodorou was competing tonight, and we're really excited to see what he can do.
Yeah, he had a lot of hype behind him. He won the Ultimate Fighter Nations, Canada versus Australia, in 2014, and he had a great record in the UFC.
Absolutely. Was 8-3 when he parted ways with the UFC, and this is his first fight in Prospect Fighting Championships.
I've never heard of that. feels great. It feels great to not only be in the win column, but do so with the finish. If for the long time I've been able to win, because that's what I do, but I'm excited to be able to finish fights again and looking to take this into the new year and come back out there.
So what was your record in the UFC?
8-3.
8-3.
And I was also the first Canadian to win the Ultimate Fighter as well. So if you count the Ultimate Fighter, it's probably like 11-3.
No doubt. That's a stellar record, especially if in the UFC, it was a world-class fighter.
Yeah, and I reached the height of 12th best in the world.
No doubt.
Fought some of the best. I even went the distance to some of the, like, my only losses were decisions to some of the best as well. Absolutely. I only lost great people. One of those would happen to be Thiago Santos. I won a split decision with him, and it was only the latter round that I lost that I think otherwise I would have beaten someone like Thiago Santos, who arguably beat John Jones.
He beat John Jones, he's top of the fight problem. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. That's actually, again, there's no easy fights in the UFC.
No,
I mean, there's nobody to push.
And in many ways, in mixed martial arts, what differs is there's no easy fights in general, right? That's the difference between boxing and MMA.
Sure. Now, if you don't mind me asking, what caused you to leave the UFC? Because you've got, still a record. Unusual for someone with that kind of record to leave the UFC.
Yeah,
you're doing very well.
Yeah, well, I think there are many different things. First and foremost, I think, because I won so much, I think my paycheck got to a certain point where essentially it's just a business in the sense that they hired 6 or 7 new Canadian fighters, right, and they could basically pay my whole paycheck with 6 or 7 fighters, right?
Yeah,
so I think it was a business decision in that capacity. Also, in many ways, I think my style for the longest time, very much, I looked at mixed martial arts as a sport, so I was looking to win rather than looking to get in a brawl. But obviously, I've gone back to the drawing board and come back to basically my roots, both fighting at home and also fighting style and the ability of a grinder who will pick you up, throw you, and try and break your will, and that's what I did tonight.
Absolutely.
And also, I think third and last, I've been very outspoken in regards to my fundamental right to medicate with medical cannabis.
Yep.
And I think that rubbed the powers that be in regards to USADA. But I'm still very committed, and I'm excited that in 2020, I know, because it's in the works, I will be setting precedent as the first cannabis athlete, which will set precedent not only for myself but all other athletes, to medicate as prescribed by their doctor, and
absolutely,
no longer have to take first-line medications like painkillers and opioids that have detrimental effects them, not only as patients but also as athletes, because it's the side effects as well that are a hindrance to your ability. It's still a banned substance, especially for instance, like for USADA, which was with the UFC, it's the United States Anti-Doping Agency, and they get their funding by the U.S. government, which still looks at cannabis as a Schedule I drug.
Sure.
And because they get their funding from the United States, that they look at cannabis as a Schedule I drug, so there's no medical problems. But now, no longer with a U.S. company, I can go a very Canadian way and plant my flag, not only for myself, but all other athletes and practice stigma. I have many different companies and partnerships that I have. One of them that was in the stands tonight was Hemp Energy Drink.
Yep.
Again, I'm trying to remove the stigma of medical cannabis, but also remove the stigma of the plant as well.
Sure.
And that would be hemp in that capacity. So it's delicious. Yeah, they're delicious.
I had one of the raspberry ones.
Yeah, cross the raspberry, bro.
Absolutely. Too cool, man. Congratulations. Great performance. Thank you very much for speaking
to us, man.
Best of luck to you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, man.
In the main event, TJ Laramie fought Andrew Cruz for the Prospect Fighting Championship's featherweight title. He won a unanimous 5-round decision in a very tough fight. It was really good. It was a great performance.
Yeah, absolutely. There was a lot of other celebrities there that night. We ran into Chris Clements, like I said, Elias Theodorou, D'Lo Brown was there, and Adam Troopish as well.
Definitely. It was a good night. We had a fantastic time, you know, really enjoyed the fights, really enjoyed the atmosphere. Want to thank all the fighters for coming out and giving it 100%, as well as all the officials, Jamie Champion for putting it all together, and everybody that made this fight happen. It was a real good time.
It was a great day.
Definitely. See you at the fights.